Hello everybody, welcome to our channel Guruku. Today we are going to talk about the one very important shot which is using lot in the match, and clay court is in the clay court match it is used, okay, and it is very easy to get point but little bit tricky. That one is drop shot. So first we know the what is the drop shot. What I said before, that if you will learn anything, we have to put 5 questions in front of the learning. First, what, why, when, where, and how. But most of the people is learning how to do. This is the totally wrong concept. Because of that, players are not improving. Coaches are also not focusing. But I always, last my 35 years experience, I do the same pattern. Because of that, I am very successful in this field, and my players are doing very good. But who want to play nice tennis? If I will do and players don't do, can't help, okay? So sometime, you know, now we are going to talk about the drop shot. So what is the drop shot? Drop shot is the shot when we keep the ball near the net. We keep the ball, short ball to the net. It is not a long ball, it is a short ball. When I'm going to put in the whiteboard and I'm going to explain everything, first I'm doing here and then I'm going to put the in the whiteboard also. So if I will, this is the, what type of shot? This shot is the slice, okay? This is the underspin shot. So if I will do like this, and ball will be bouncing near the net. This is the drop shot. Then why we are doing? Why we are doing? This is the big question. The question is why we are doing? Because if I am playing nowadays, the most of the match is going to the from the baseline. If you are playing baseline, if your opponent is staying back and keeping all the ball like a pusher, keeping the ball 10, 20 balls, then you can sometimes you can give the short ball. So your opponent has to run, because who are playing from the baseline, they are mostly 90% player, they hate volley and the net play. So you can use this and you can get the point. So why point is finished? Then we have to talk about where this is the one of the best question. We can if our opponent will from the baseline, very far from the baseline or over the baseline, other side of the baseline. So first time I can give the drop shot here, but you can see if I give the drop shot here, my opponent is in the center, he can run more faster and get the ball. But so if I keep the ball in this corner, then what happens? My opponent have to run and come to the little bit angle, okay, close to the net post here, and then he need to run more. And if he will come here, then whole court is open. So mostly the drop shot where to hit the ball the sideline, near the sideline, any sideline. Don't drop shot in the center. It is okay, but it is not that effective. So where also is finished. Now the vital one is the when. Then I'm going to demonstrate also about that. When to hit. So very simple thing. You can't give the drop shot. If I can't give the drop shot when I am behind the baseline. Because if I stay behind the baseline and then I give the drop shot, if my opponent will come, the second thing is it is ball is traveling little more far, so maybe my opponent will get the point. Second one, if he will give me the again drop shot, then I need to run fast and then maybe I'm in the trouble. So always try to give the drop shot when I am in the inside the court. That means near the baseline or inside the baseline or in the no man's land, okay? So from there I can give drop shot, so opponent can't get it, okay? So that is the when. And now the thing is the how. What I said that before, this is a slice technique, okay? This is the underspin technique. So for that, in underspin we have to do the, our racket is a little bit open like a same slice, but we don't go the long back swing and we don't go the forward. We are going this much, okay? So from here to here, So it's only, okay, so only that much. So that one we are going to do that, how you do. So this is the thing, the same thing in the back, okay. So little bit, short backswing and just touch, like a touch game, okay, little bit. So that one, this is the how. But we need to improve that thing, how we can improve for the kids and other player to develop the drop shot. So let's start. Now, I'm putting the cone here and then I'm going to give the ball to them. They will do the slice here, okay? So let's see how they are doing. So this is the, just close to the knee. I'm putting a circle. They are trying to keep the ball there, okay? Ready? Two balls each. Okay, ready, go. Slice and drop shot. Okay, next one more. Okay, next, good one. This, okay, back. Now I'm going to do combination drop shot. So they can't do the drop shot only. So when we are doing the drop shot, this is the combination technique. Then your forehand or backhand should be more powerful, so your opponent will be stay back and then you will give the drop shot, okay? This is the combination. Otherwise, any ball you can't give the drop shot. So if you can't push your opponent back, then you can't give the drop shot. So if you can't push your opponent back, so before the drop shot, your shot should be more powerful. So opponent will be struggle and try to return the ball very softly, and then they will give the drop shot. This is the combination. Drop shot is a combination of the two shots, okay? One is the powerful to keep the opponent back and then give the drop shot, okay? This is the very important. So this is, I'm going for the next progression. Ready? Two balls, one hard, boom. And then drop shot. Come on. Yeah, good. Back, this line, huh? Okay, and then drop shot. Okay, little more from baseline now. One. This, okay, next, this, okay, this, how much, okay, they cut out, watch the ball and then come, if ball is a little bit short, then you come, you are running very fast, okay, so sometime you can see this, one, this one, okay, and this. That is the another one. I can do the more progression. One forehand, one backhand, then drop shot. Also, can it be possible? Okay. This. Okay. Two. Okay. This. No. One. Okay. Two. Okay. Three. Okay. Good one. Good one. Nine. This one. This. Okay. This one. That's good. So now you can see, you can make it hundreds of combination with the different type of, with the inside out also you can do. So next time I'm going to do the inside out also, okay? Because if you are inside out, you are hitting the ball to the opponent backhand and then ball will be short and then he will be in the backhand side, you give the ball here. So let's see, I'm doing one more combination, okay, for you to understand. There are hundred type of combination you can make. This is very simple, okay? Just I'm trying to do this. Ready, faster. This side, forehand this side, then forehand drop shot here, okay? Ready? Go. One. Okay, then inside out. Go. Okay, and then go to the drop shot. That's good one. Next. One. Okay, inside out, turn more. Okay, and then go and drop shot. Yeah, that's good one. This one.
Okay, this one, nice. And this one go there. This is not good. One. Okay. Come on. Go around the ball. Yes, good one. Last. Prince, come on. One. Okay. Two. Go. Very nice. And this one. Drop shot. Oh, that's good. So now you can see how they are doing. So I'm doing the one more. That one is the hitting the forehand, then backhand, and then they will give the drop shot. I will give the one big forehand down the line, then ball will come here and they will turn and do the little bit inside out drop shot. That also we can see how they are doing, because they are good. Let's see how they are doing. That's great one. This one, okay, and then turn and try to this one. One more, this, good, and this way, and drop over the net, Prince. Ready, this, okay, and this one, turn. That's good, it's long. And this, and this one, and this one bounce, two bounce. So important is, when you give the drop shot, your first bounce will bounce inside the box, second ball also bounce inside the box. Then it is almost 90% a good drop shot. If ball will bounce here, first bounce in the box, second bounce is going over the service line, that means your opponent will get the ball easily. So that is also very important, okay? So now, the last I'm going to show that, like you are hitting very hard, but you are changing you disguise the shot, okay? This also a drop shot. So I want to give all the type. So this is the last one, okay? Try to show on forehand, the same thing. You try to, one, okay? And this one try to hit hard and drop, okay? This side, target. One, okay? And then it is coming, and, see, your opponent will understand that you are going to hit very hard. Opponent will understand you are hitting very hard. And then sometime in the same grip, you can do like this. That also can help. So I hope I can clear all this. Next, more advanced drop shot, which one is a little bit tricky. That one we are going to do in the next time, okay? So I hope, thank you very much for watching. I hope I cleared this concept and this drop shot with our five key question, which one is I like most. That one is the important. When you teach anybody, you always try to use this five key question, and it is going to work very nicely. So player can understand is completely. So what is this, why we are doing, where we are doing, when we are doing, and then how we are doing, okay? So how is the last, but most of the people are doing, how is the first? So don't do this, try to do what I am telling you. If you like, this is a nice, if you see it is good, you try it, okay? There is no copyright for that, okay? I'm giving for everybody. Thank you, bye-bye.